Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to the maths class. So you all know that we have completed exercise 8.1 in our previous class. So today onwards, we will be starting exercise 8.2 with question number 1. So the question number 1 states that convert the given fractional numbers to percent. So the fraction number is given here, the first question. So you have to convert this number into percentage. Okay, so any number, whenever you have to convert any number, whether it is fraction, whether it is non-fraction, so to convert that number into percentage, you have to just multiply with 100. Keep that in your mind. Just have to multiply with 100, you will get the percentage. How? First of all, you have to divide this, multiply this, and cut whatever is needed to be cut. Like here, 2 4s are 8. 250, right? And 50 can be deducted more. So 2 2s are 4, 2 25s are, now it will be 25 by 2. Yes? So when you, it's better, instead of keeping this, you can keep the percentage over here also, but instead of keeping this in a fraction, it's better you divide and get the value in a decimal form, right? So it is 2 12s are 24, 5 minus 4 is 1 here, then 0.0, 2 5s are 10, right? So what is the answer? 12.5. So your answer is 12.5%. Alright, so you can copy now. Remember, whatever the number is given, just have to multiply it with 100 and get the number. If it is whole number, if it is not in decimal, it's well and good, but if it is coming in the decimal form, it's better you convert in a decimal number. Okay, so proceeding to the part B, we have, as I have mentioned, any number, whatever is the number, multiply with 100. Now 4 1s are 4, 4 25s are 100. Yes, so now when you multiply this, 5 into 25 is 125. So don't forget to put this percentage sign, because you are converting into percentage. Okay, it is very, very important. Whenever the question is asked to convert into the percentage, then it's very important to put the percentage sign over here, this one. Okay, so proceeding to part C, we have 3 by 40. Okay, so in this part also, what we are going to do is we are going to multiply with 100. All right, okay, but before that, you will put the 100 in the middle, in the center of this fraction, not over here or not over here, because you have to multiply at the center over here. Okay, so now what you can do, 0 can be deducted, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. Now I don't think anything can be deducted over here, so you have to multiply. 3 5s are 15 divided by 2 1s are 2. Over here you can just consider it as 1, so 2 1s are 2. So now whenever you divide this, you have to convert, as I have mentioned, into the decimal form, right? So 2 7s are 14, 1.0, so it is 7.5, right? So it is, the percentage is 7.5%. Okay, so this is the way to do it. Okay, proceeding to the last part of the question from number 1, we have to convert 2 by 7, this fraction, into decimal, sorry, into percentage. So this will be your home assignment. I hope till now, the concept to convert the given fraction into percentage is clear. So I want you all to try yourself. So if any problem you have, you can comment me down, okay? So let us proceed to question number 2. Okay, student, proceeding to the next question, question number 2 we have, convert the given decimal fractional numbers to percent. Okay, now the decimal number is given, okay? So the decimal numbers should be converted into the percentage. Okay, it is also the easiest one. Over here also, what you have to do, you have to multiply the given number with the 100 only. First of all, 0.65, you write this number. After that, you put 1 divide. Why? To remove this point, remove the point write 1. For this point you will write 1. After point, how many digits are there? 2, right? 1 and 2. So you'll write 2, 0. Now this is your fraction. How we did in the previous question, the fraction was given. Over here the decimal is given. So what we did, decimal is converted now into fractional form. Now it can be written as 65/100. Now we have to convert this number into percentage. So you multiply with 100, because this is the only form through which we get our percentage, right? So 100 can be deducted, because 100 ones is 100. So 65 ones is 65. So your answer is 65%. Alright children, now you can copy. So 0.65, whenever you are converting into percentage, this is 65%. Alright. So proceeding to the part B, we have, first of all write 2.1. Remove this point, write 1 below in the denominator part. After the decimal, how many? After the decimal point, how many digits are there? 1. So write single 0. It depends on the digits after the decimal. So 1 digit after the decimal, so 10 into 100. Over here only you can write. So it is 21/10 into 100. So you can cut the 0. Yes. And it is 21 into 10. It is 210%. It is 210%. Okay. So 21 into 10 is 210. Proceeding to the part C, 0.02 in should be converted into fraction, into a percentage. First of all, you convert this into the fractional form. After the point, there are two digits, that's why 20 into 100. Now, when you remove this point, this zero will automatically get removed. Until and unless you don't remove the point, this zero will remain here. When you remove this point, this zero will also moved out. So now it is 2/100 into 100. This 100 can be deducted. Now it is 2 ones are 2. This 2%. All right. I hope you have understood this. The last part of the question, 12.35. Let's do this as a home assignment. So submit your work. Okay. Any doubt, you can comment me down. Okay. This much for today, children. In our next class, we will proceed with the question number 3. Okay. Thank you, everyone.